Welcome to Travel Scope with Joseph Rosendo, where each week you join us as we accept the world's invitation to visit.
Today on Travel Scope, I take a Caribbean escape on St. Vincent and the Grenadines. Along the way, I enjoy a few cultural surprises.
Travel Scope is made possible by DK Eyewitness Travel Guides, DK City, Country, and Driving Guides feature evocative photos, 3D mapping, and illustrations for key sites and travel itineraries. DK Eyewitness Travel Guides, the guides that show you what others only tell you. And Rosetta Stone, changing the way the world learns languages.
32 beautiful islands off the beaten track, yet in your backyard. Join me on my St. Vincent and the Grenadines adventure. Yahoo! The lure of a Caribbean island escape is irresistible. Each year, more than 20 million tourists give in to the temptation. Yet on St. Vincent and the Grenadines, you can avoid the well-worn tourist track by meeting the people, diving headfirst into the destination, and getting below surface amusements. The underwater world. What's the underwater world like here?
It's beautiful. We really have some of the best diving in the Caribbean. Lots of big sea fans, beautiful hard corals, a wide diversity of fish that you're not going to find anywhere else.
Beautiful.
And the best thing? Very few divers.
Well, thank you for taking me down under. And I don't mean Australia.
You're very welcome.
There are hundreds of species of aquatic life to discover in St. Vincent's waters. And while for most of us they are objects of color and beauty, for the fishermen of Clare Valley, they are a way of life.
Yeah, it'll reach all Barbados, Grenada, St. Lucia, and take us whole day. Lost the land, don't see nothing at all. Just traveling in the ocean. Miles and miles of water. Yes, really good life, but really rough out there sometimes.
So are you from this valley?
Yeah, I'm from here, originally born here, from Clear Valley.
Well, it's nice. It's a beautiful setting.
Thank you.
Wow, lovely place for hanging out and swimming.
Yeah, and relaxing as well.
And relaxing?
Yeah, yeah.
How much fish do you guys take out every day?
Yeah. Hey, so, look, okay, just Sunday, one boat bringing 1,000 pounds.
1,000 pounds
yeah,
of fish?
Fish, yeah, just one boat. Three men go out in each boat. One boat usually go bottom line, bring the snappers.
Bringing in the snappers
Yeah, big angle. Yeah. I mean, and the other one go to draw the dolphin.
It's all hand line or netting?
No hand line.
There's no separation between you and the fish?
Well, if you comment, I mean, both of us could go out and try fishing some bottom line. If you have the opportunity,
we use a small boat and go. That sounds good.
But let's see. Carry the crew as well.
Yeah, if we could maybe do that.
Good morning, brother.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you for doing this. This is great. This man's called Fisherman. Must be a real honor to be called a fisherman among fishermen.
Fishing every day.
Every day for how long?
For all my life, from since I go to school.
It's quite a life. So how old are you?
I'm 64.
64, all right. Yeah. You're in much better shape than I am. And I'm younger than you.
Oh, well, that is life, you know. I work very hard.
Yes.
In my young days, I'm not still working hard. I feel just as if I'm 16.
Well, good.
So, the body has
16 till you die. That's the way it is. Okay, I'm dropping right in here.
Okay, well, you go ahead.
Okay.
Let it come.
Here we go.
Let's get some fish, man.
Let's get it. Let's get a big one.
Yeah, man.
Okay. I've fished all my life, and in my youth, my father took me to fish from the bridges and causeway of Miami with a hand line. And although we ate what we caught, there is a difference between fishing for fun and fishing for food.
Do you feel anything else yet?
Not yet. Oh, yeah, right there. I felt something there.
Looks like you have something there, man.
Whoa!
You're a fisherman, man. Beautiful. You're the big fisherman, Felipe.
So, well, thank you very much, Mr. Fisherman. We'll throw this little sucker back.
You catch fish, man, don't shoot it.
Don't shoot it away.
Huh?
Let me not shoot it away.
Okay. You catch it, you keep it. But you know what they say, a bad day of fishing is a lot better than any other day. Thank you so much.
Praise God for that, man.
Praise God.
The sea is a source of life for the islanders, but so is the fresh water that runs through their rivers and streams. At Darkview Falls, one of St. Vincent's natural attractions, the self-sufficiency and resourcefulness of the people are on display.
This is where the river is diverted to the catchment for hydroelectricity generation.
So the hydroelectric plant is run basically from the speed that the river is running now as it goes downhill.
That's all that it takes to provide that electricity. The country produces about 20-22% hydroelectricity in general. But for mainland St. Vincent, we produce up to about 30%.
Oh, but as the world's turning green, it's becoming very popular now. Here in St. Vincent and the Grenadines, you've been doing this for a long time.
We've been doing it for 50 years.
Well, let's go see the mother of all this.
Exactly. We go over to Darkview Falls. This bridge was actually built out of sheer necessity.
Yes?
We found ourselves trapped quite a few times on the other side of the river. And I came up with a design, a crew of 7 or 8. We built it in a day.
But people have lived on these islands for a long time, haven't they? How long?
Yes, people have been living here for thousands of years. They were the Siboneyes and the Garifuna people.
You know, I've heard and read that the people from the Caribbean being called something different, like Caribs.
Garifuna is the original name of the indigenous people.
Are there still any Garifuna left?
I am Garifuna. Oh. There are lots of proud Garifuna in St. Vincent and the Grenadines and across Central America. Gotta be careful.
Oh, look at here.
Yeah.
A little slippery.
Yeah, it's a little slippery.
This is fabulous.
It is.
What's the drop?
It's still to be determined.
Still to be determined.
Still to be determined.
This looks wonderful.
Yeah.
Can you swim here?
You can get in. It's clean. It's wonderful. It's a shower.
Oh, okay. That's good enough with me.
Great.
happiness is a waterfall shower. Rasto, this is magnifico. Thank you for introducing me to St. Vincent's natural side.
Feel welcome, man.
My exploration of St. Vincent's natural side continues on the Vermont Nature Trail, which includes the St. Vincent Parrot Reserve, more than 10,000 acres of rainforest set aside to protect the endangered St. Vincent parrot. Only 720 parrots remain in the wild, so it's difficult to catch them on the wing. Yet all are guaranteed an up-close experience at the Nichols Wildlife Complex.
This bird is so important to St. Vincent. It is like saving the St. Vincent parrot, saving the forest. It's saving lives on St. Vincent.
Almost as indigenous as the St. Vincent parrot is breadfruit. It is grown along with other crops such as bananas and yams in the rich volcanic soil of the Mesopotamia Valley, the island's breadbasket. Along with jackfish, it is the main component in the national dish. I joined Christopher John, Young Island Resort Chef, on a search for ingredients at the Kingstown Saturday Market.
This is wonderful. This market takes place every Saturday?
Every Saturday, yeah. From 4 in the morning till 3 in the afternoon.
4 till 3 in the afternoon?
Yeah, everybody come and get them up there.
Now, most of the ingredients here, are they from the islands, or are they imported, or what?
Yeah, they're grown locally.
Stuff like the...
Like yams.
Yams.
Dashing, passion fruit.
Now, we're after jackfish and breadfruit.
Yes, sir.
Breadfruit has been around on the islands for centuries.
Yes, sir.
Brought to you by old Captain Bly, the mutiny guy.
Yeah, breadfruit can use us like a potato. You can't do anything with it.
All right, so this is the one you're after?
Yeah, we're going to buy this one.
$6.22.
Okay,
yeah, well, I can be your assistant. I can't cook, but at least I can hold.
We're going to cook it later.
Let's see, what else are we going to need here?
Jackfish.
Well, let's go to the fish market. So, chef, do you have a favorite place to get your fish?
Yeah, right here. Whenever I need my fish, I come right here.
Every chef has his favorite place.
We're going to get this one.
That's fabulous.
Yeah.
Okay. Great. That's the dish to have on Saturday, right?
That's the dish to have. Jackfish.
Okay, chef, let's go up and do it. Thank you very much. Have a great day.
Okay, thank you.
Young Island is the northernmost of the 31 islands that make up the Grenadines. Only 200 yards and a 5-minute boat ride from St. Vincent's South Shore, it is a privately owned 35-acre resort offering luxury suites and a perfect white sand beach for the chef and me to work on our breadfruit and jackfish. There it is. Is it done?
Yeah, it's done. Ready for action?
I'm ready for action. Okay, here we go. Right below this whole area, right?
Yeah, that's what it is.
It tastes like potatoes.
Yeah, very nice.
Almost has a mashed potato taste to it. Chef, are these fish, the jackfish, is it pretty plentiful on the island?
It's a popular fish on the island.
And it's become part of the heritage and a national dish.
Part of culture, yes, everything.
Part of the culture.
Yeah. That's all jackfish.
A little sauce on top, yeah, look at that. Woo. Here we are, jackfish and breadfruit, the national dish of St. Vincent and the Grenadines. Thank you, Chef.
Thank you, sir.
Although breadfruit is embraced as the island's national fruit, it was originally brought to the Caribbean by the British as a cheap food for slaves. While other Caribbean nations have a long history of slavery and colonial rule, the Caribs and Garifuna of St. Vincent resisted European settlement for nearly 200 years, including fighting two wars led by national hero Joseph Catuay, which is why the English cannons at Fort Charlotte face inland instead of out to sea. Thanks to the fierce resistance, St. Vincent and the Grenadines experienced only 40 years of slavery. Yet that was plenty of time for the sugar plantations to flourish and for the infamous Black Point Tunnel to be built.
So the sugar was brought in from these plantations that came from off Beira and the Grand Sable Estates. Hull flew all 360 feet of this tunnel here and loaded onto the wharf on the western end of the tunnel. Now, this tunnel was constructed using African slave labor.
How many slaves do you think worked on an operation like this?
Something like this would have been upwards of 700, 750.
And how many do you think died in the process of building it?
Anyway, up to 500 or more.
Look at that sea.
This is ground zero. We're approaching this structure. This would have been one of the major supporting arms of the wharf itself.
And the wharf went right out in that direction?
Yes, 40 meters out.
You mentioned earlier that the black slaves were the ones who did the construction of the tunnel, but that the Caribs, the indigenous people, were the people who did the loading of the sugar onto the ships. Why was the jobs broken up and distinct like that?
The Caribs are very skilled, very experienced seamen. And so because of that particular skill, it was considered best to use those groups of people to load produce onto the ships.
Well, it's certainly a resourceful combination of people.
St. Vincent and the Grenadines really epitomizes a mixture of people from the African and the European and the South American continent, and all intermixing these islands, the archipelago of the Caribbean.
In SVG, you meet people from all walks of life, and the best experiences are those right under your nose. A short walk from the cruise ship terminal, I sample life in the rum shops of St. Vincent's Chinatown.
My grandfather used to play this game.
What about you?
I don't think I'm good enough to play with you guys. This would be fun to play just because you can make so much noise.
I just started the game. You got to know.
Yeah, but I know. You got to know. There's strategy. I know.
Well, we just see.
The louder you slap it down, the better you're likely to win.
That's the beauty of
for you to see.
The noise.
The noise. Okay. Yeah. It makes it fun. Like that. This area is called the rum shop.
Chinatown.
Chinatown. Yeah. Nobody's here Chinese.
No.
Were there Chinese here at one time?
Yeah.
Oh, the whole area was Chinese.
Creole Chinese.
Creole Chinese. Area,
yeah.
But right now it's like the rum shops. It's a rum shop.
Yeah. Local liquor.
People come up.
Have you tasted the local liquor?
I've tasted the local beer.
The beer? What about the strong rum?
No, I haven't tried.
Get him a glass and some water.
Right here in your doorway. He's going to teach me how to do this.
You want a chaser? You got a chaser. I got a bitter lemon, local drink also.
Okay.
Okay. Right, I'll let you try that. And if you could go, I'll give you another one.
No. Okay, but...
Another glass.
That's like fire. That is very strong rum. I think the reason it's called sunset is because after you have a while, the sun sets.
Exactly.
Take care. Okay, guys.
From the ferry terminal, it's an hour to Bekwe, SVG's second largest island. Bekwe offers many Caribbean island pleasures, such as beachfront eateries serving local foods and drinks. Yet what sets it apart from the rest are its whaling and boat building past, and a new interest in wildlife conservation.
I am here now 14 and a half years. I started small.
How did this begin, yes?
Well, this thing began like a dream. I actually was sleeping in a tent out here one night by myself. So a turtle came up, dug her hole right at the edge of my tent door, and laid her eggs and went back. And being there to see them hatch, I said, this is a sign and I have to do something about it. I have already released 869 four-year-old ones.
How are things progressing? Are the local people now starting to understand that they shouldn't kill and eat turtles, or
well,
what?
Well, one of my biggest successes here, you know, is that I'm teaching children, and they are promising me that they will not eat turtles.
Now, it's called the Old Hague Turtle Sanctuary.
Yes.
Where'd you get that name?
I fished with my grandfather when I was a boy. And when we put out his nets, sometimes you will get this little turtle full of barnacles because they are deformed, and they name them the Old Hague. Old Hague is like a witch.
I see.
You see?
The old hag.
The old hag.
I get it.
I happen to get one.
Well, she doesn't look very ugly.
No, she's beautiful in color, but in her shape, she's different. The breastplate is not flat. It is half wrong, so it cannot make any speed.
Here, she's doing pretty well?
She's safe.
You know, what I've found in my history and the places I've traveled around the world, that if anything is to be preserved, it always comes down to individual people doing it.
Yeah.
Like yourself, people like yourself.
Yes. It is amazing what one man can do.
For a barefoot luxury experience, I joined Captain John and Cook Ruthie aboard the local Hero.
Hey, welcome aboard.
For a day sail to lovely Tobago Cays. Sailing with or without a crew is a favorite pastime in the Grenadines.
Good morning on the local Hero. The grocery store comes to you, and we got some ice for the ice chest, a little pan chocolate delivered right to us. And then, of course, they made some breakfast here aboard the local Hero. I mean, what a wonderful morning. Get out of bed, jump into the ocean, great sea breezes, beautiful skies. I mean, really, what more do you want? This is the life.
Protecting underwater life is one of the aims of the Tobago Cays National Marine Park. A refuge for a host of sea creatures, its shallow, crystal-clear, warm waters make it possible for even snorkelers to swim with endangered sea turtles. On Berardel, one of the five islands that make up the park, wildlife conservation goes on.
Let's go see if we can find some of these iguanas.
Okay, it looks like this is the perfect home for iguanas.
Well, it's an absolute perfect habitat. And there's a small one right there in the bush.
Oh, I can see him.
Now, we actually released him 3 days ago, and he hasn't left the bush yet.
Okay.
And as I'm looking down here, I noticed that on the trunk down the bottom is...
Oh, look at that beauty.
...is old Fred. And that's how the whole iguana program started. I was walking in Kenawan one day, and Fred was
on... Kenawan being one of the islands here in the Grenadines.
And Fred there was tied up to a piece of stick, and someone was taking him home to eat.
Oh.
And I happened to say, how much for that iguana? And $45. And I thought, what a great idea. Bring him to the Tobago Cays and release him.
It's not because the people are bad. It's because if you have a family, you have to survive.
You know, there's no free cheese in St. Vincent and the Grenadines. Well, look up in that tree. There's another one right there.
Okay, she's okay. We're not going to scare her off.
You know what? These iguanas just want to be left in peace to eat and breed. They're not violent. They're not aggressive. If you cornered them, they would just whip you with their tail, but they're not aggressive. We're just going to move nice and slow. She's not alarmed. Look how big her belly is. She's ready to have babies.
So, Phil, most of the iguanas that are here on the island now were captured at one time.
Absolutely.
But the idea is that you'll have a whole community of iguanas here that are born free.
Well, the most thrilling part for me is to see babies that are now running around. They've never been caught, fabulous. Never been harassed. And so Tobago Keys is living proof. Everything comes back,
right.
Apart from my hair.
Well, sorry about your hair, but congratulations on what you've done.
Well, thank you, sir.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay, Joseph, right now we're anchored just to the east of Barrowdale Island, right in front of Horseshoe Reef. And we're going to head down to Union Island. What we're going to do is pass out between Petit Bateau and James B. And we need to negotiate our way around all of these coral heads here. What we're going to do is line up the tip of this island with the tip of that island, and then we know we're in the clear.
And you'll stay clear because of your instrumentation will keep you clear of the corals?
Well, we might, but you can't always depend on that stuff. No. And this is the old-fashioned way. You just can't go wrong with it. It's not going to be a long journey. We've got, let's see, 4 nautical miles door-to-door. Okay?
Well, let's
go.
Okay, go, 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 go. Timber me timber. Abash ye, mateys. Woo-hoo!
That should do it.
Yeah, let's
make it off at the top.
Make it off.
And that's it.
It's official. We're sailing now.
Yeah, we are. Won't be too long. We'll definitely be there in time for cocktail hour.
Good thing. Woo-hoo! Slavery persisted in St. Vincent and the Grenadines until 1834. Each year, Union Island pays homage to its African culture at the Maroon Festival, which simply means giving thanks for the coming planting season. As part of the Maroon Festival, there's a big drum dance. They practice for it all year. Thank you for joining me on my St. Vincent and the Grenadines adventure. Each year, thousands of travelers head to the Caribbean for an island escape. Freedom from their workaday world and its challenges. St. Vincent and the Grenadines easily fills the bill and makes their dreams come true. Yet, in spite of azure seas and brilliant skies, magnificent resorts, and white and black sand beaches, St. Vincent and the Grenadines offers more than just a sun and fun holiday. A long, proud history of resistance and struggle for freedom and independence has created a very special Caribbean. Confident, determined, self-assured Caribbean who continues to preserve and celebrate their multifaceted cultural heritage and will happily share it with you. Till next time, this is Joseph Rosendo, reminding you of the words of Mark Twain, travel is fatal to prejudice, bigotry, and narrow-mindedness. Happy traveling.
TravelScope is made possible by DK Eyewitness Travel Guides. DK City, Country, and Driving Guides feature evocative photos, 3D mapping, and illustrations for key sites and travel itineraries. DK Eyewitness Travel Guides, the guides that show you what others only tell you. And Rosetta Stone, changing the way the world learns languages. For a DVD of today's show, or any of Joseph's Travel Scope adventures, call 888-876-3399 or order online at travelscope.net. You can also email us at tv@travelscope.net or write us at the address on your screen.
Now that we've escaped to St. Vincent and the Grenadines, learn more at travelscope.net, where you can follow my adventures through my e-magazine, blog, and podcasts. Keep in touch, 888-876-3399 or tv@travelscope.net.
Question.
What language are you speaking?
English. English, English.
That was English?
Yeah.
Local English. All the time.
All the time. But isn't there a local language?
It might be a little fast for you.